Hi, this is Debbie, and I am talking to you from my car. I am so excited. I've just been up to my cousin's to have my computer service for the month, and I was able to pick up a little camera for the car a few weeks ago at a very reasonable price. Had to wait for him to install it, of course. Anyway, it appears to be working, and I'm really thrilled about it. And today I wanted to talk to you about somebody I met at the airport the other day. Well, yesterday I was on my way home to Wellington. And I had my little granddaughter's balloon because she gave it to me as a present to bring it home. And I needed to bring it home, take a photo of it, so that she could see that I had brought it home. She's only three, the little darling. Anyway, I'm sitting at the airport with this balloon, pumped up balloon, sitting on my knee because my granddaughter didn't give me the stick, did she? So I'm having to carry it around by the little nozzle thing. And I sat by this lady and she said, "You're not taking that on the plane, are you?" I said, "Well, yes, I am." And she said, "Well, what if it goes, what if it pops? I'll get a very big fright." She said, "I hope I'm not sitting anywhere near you because honestly, I will just get such a fright if it pops." And I thought, "Oh, okay." I said, "Oh, well, maybe I could undo it, I thought, "Oh, maybe I could undo it from the little nozzle thing that's got on the opening to the balloon." And I started to do that, and then she said, "Well, what if that does happen and you let it go, and then it'll go blowing around the cabin, and that'll give everybody a fright as well. I mean, no matter what I did with this balloon, she was not going to be happy." And I was thinking about that, and I thought, people find a lot of excuses to not be successful. They find they're nitpicking. You get some good thing in front of you, but then they see all the funny, bad, dark sides of what could happen. But nothing did happen. In the end, I got the balloon home quite safely. It's in my mobile home. I've taken a photo of it so my granddaughter can see it. And this lady quite worried me because I thought, well, maybe it might pop. Wouldn't that be terrible in the cabin? That would be like a terrorist gun going off or something like that. Anyway, I asked the people, as they were boarding the plane, I said to the hostess, "Is it all right if I take my balloon on plane?" "Yes, of course, no problem." So they were quite happy for me to take it, and in the end, nothing happened. But this is how people talk themselves out of things. They find all the wrong things about something instead of just letting it go and see what happens. And I wanted to tell you that today because it really concerned me about her attitude as to whether a lot of people on my team, who are going to be on my team, who want to be on my team, who may be in the future, have that attitude as well. So you've got to have a very clear vision in your head as to where you're going, what you want to do, what vehicle you're going to use to get you where you want to go. And don't forget this little red balloon. Whenever you have a doubt, think of the red balloon. Nothing happened. And it actually was a joy for my granddaughter Nadine that I was able to bring it home and remember her when I got home 500 miles away from where she lives. Anyway, I wanted to leave you that thought today, and I will talk to you again in my car at another time about another subject. Thank you for listening. I really appreciate you listening to me on my videos and reading my blogs. Just click on any of the links in my blogs below and below this video, and you can get in touch with me and let's get into your future. Okay, goodbye.